What about spin population? We can see that in the we can see that in transition state, superoxide unit has almost same amount of spin density as in starting aqua superoxide complex, but in this species there is a much smaller amount of spin density on hydroperoxide unit, and it's alpha spin now instead of beta spin, and there is some small spin amount on hydroxide unit. At the second more stable hydroxy hydroperoxy unit, amount of spin on hydroxy unit on hydroxy unit is a bit larger, and amount of spin on hydroperoxy unit is correspondingly a bit smaller than in this compound. Again, both ruthenium's are in oxidation state 4, and as we can see from this number, this superoxy unit, sorry, this hydroxy hydroperoxy unit is formation of this hydroxy hydroperoxy unit is exothermic by almost 20 kilocalories per mole in gas phase and 10 kilocalories per mole in water, and formation of this molecule is exothermic by close amount of energies compared relative to the original to the original reactant. Okay, now what about the last step, transformation of hydroxy hydroperoxy unit to the reaction product with two ruthenium oxo groups and water molecule coordinated. It proceeds through this transition state where oxygen bond in hydroperoxy group is broken, and proton is transferred from hydroxy group from this hydroxy group to this breaking apart hydroxy group. So, and we have both in transition state and in the reaction product, both ruthenium's in oxidation state 4. So this is two electron oxidation step. We would expect that both ruthenium's should have oxidation state 5 because they are oxygen atoms bound to them. But due to high oxidation stability of ruthenium's in oxidation state 5, they pull one electron from their corresponding oxygens, and now oxygens in this oxo group bear almost one spin each. So these groups have radicaloid character, and we have water molecule coordinated to them, which of course bears negligible amount of total spin. Also, what is noticeable here is significant elongation of these bond distances compared to the reactant from 2.11 angstroms to 2.60 angstroms. So this is a concerted pathway. As we can see, it proceeds through similar intermediates, aqua superoxo complex, hydroxo hydroperoxo complex, and this final product. But the water molecule which dissociates from the reactant in the first step, it doesn't go away into the solution, but remains here, bound by hydrogen bonds to the whole molecule. So as we can see, it participates at every in every reaction step, in every intermediate. Couple of words about these transition states. We are not able to identify them because of low energies of hydrogen bonds and many possible isomers due to that. So we did not include them in we did not include transition states into this reaction scheme. And here is potential energy surface of the reaction for the stepwise pathway and for the concerted pathway. As we can see, both stepwise pathway and concerted pathway are very exothermic in the gas phase, and also strongly, significantly exothermic in the with effects from water taken into account. And we can see that the highest reaction barrier is water dissociation, water molecule dissociation from the reactant observed in the stepwise pathway. Okay, now let's talk a bit about geometry differences geometry differences between polyoxymetallate and the blue dimer. So here we have original polyoxymetallate with both ruthenium in oxidation state 3, but without water molecules coordinated. And here is the final the final product of the reaction with ruthenium oxygroups. So first of all, what can we see here? If we compare bond distances between ruthenium's and framework oxygens, we can see that they are shorter in the reaction product than in this original compound. If we compare bond distances between ruthenium's and oxygens, framework oxygens bound to silicon, we can see that in the original compound, they are much shorter, of course, than in the reactant product, in the reaction product. Also, what is interesting, hydrogen bonds formed between hydroxy bridges and some framework atoms. Now let's have a look at the blue dimer. So this is just one half of the blue dimer, one ruthenium center and oxo bridge here. So if we look at the this bond distance, ruthenium in the reactant and in the product, we can see that it is also shorter in the product compared to the reactant. But if we compare it with this intermediate of the blue dimer with water molecule coordinated, we can see that this bond distance ruthenium oxa is also shorter in the final compound, and also there are some differences in bond distances between ruthenium and nitrogen atoms in the ligands, in the original compound and in the reactant. So we can see that that generally bond distances between ruthenium and nitrogen atoms in the original compound in the blue dimer are shorter than in the reactant. This is a longer expression of what I just was discussing. So calculated ruthenium oxa bond distances are shorter by 0.04 angstroms in polyoxymetallate species than in the corresponding complex of the blue dimer. It means that ruthenium oxa bond are stronger in the polyoxymetallate complex compared to the blue dimer compound. Ruthenium ligand bond distances change significantly for polyoxymetallate compound, but relatively smaller for the blue dimer, except for one ruthenium bond, except for the one ruthenium nitrogen bond, which is located in the transposition to the oxa ligand. So this bond is elongated by 0.15 angstrom. For the ruthenium 2 polyoxymetallate species, bond distances between ruthenium's and framework oxygens are shortened by approximately 0.5 angstroms when we go from the reactant to the product. So it clearly shows us stabilization of the interaction between ruthenium 2 moiety and polyoxymetallate moiety, in the final in the product of the reaction compared to the reactant. And another factor that stabilizes the reaction product is two hydrogen bonds which are formed between bridging hydroxyl groups and polyoxymethylate moiety. Therefore, the calculated large exothermicity of the reaction of dioxygen with polyoxymethylate compared to the blue dimer is not only due to the formation of strong ruthenium oxo bonds in the polyoxymethylate compound, but also because of the stabilization of the interaction of this polyoxymethylate complex in the product compared to the reactant. So, in general, oxidation of the polyoxymethylate by dioxygen was shown to be a facile 4-electron oxidation process with a maximum barrier of 23 kilocalories per mole in the gas phase and 10.5 kilocalories per mole in water. And this barrier is associated with substitution of water molecule to dioxygen molecule. During the reaction, multiplicity of spin states of participating intermediates increases steadily from singlet to septet, and oxidation states of ruthenium centers increase from plus three to plus four. Reaction product contains not ruthenium oxo groups with ruthenium's in oxidation state 5, but rather these kind of groups with ruthenium's in oxidation state 4 and oxygen bearing unpaired electrons. And therefore, water oxidation by this intermediate, this compound, is a highly endothermic and unfeasible reaction. This conclusion is drastically different to the results which were reported for the blue dimer. For example, theoretical studies from 2006 showed that water oxidation by the blue dimer is exothermic by almost 23 kilocalories per mole. Therefore, we can conclude that bridged diruthenium systems placed in different ligand environments exhibit different reactivity towards oxygen and water. Electron-rich nature of polyoxymethylate moiety compared to bipyridyl ligands in the blue dimer leads to stronger ruthenium oxo bonds and ruthenium ligand bonds compared to the blue dimer, and also to hydrogen bond formation between mu oxo groups, sorry, mu OH groups. Mu hydroxyl groups of the polyoxymethylate and polyoxymethylate framework. And it leads finally to the higher stability of the polyoxymethylate oxidized polyoxymethylate compound relative to dioxygen formation. Now we stated a question for ourselves: what would happen if we use not just silicon as a header atom, but also phosphorus and sulfur, which have, as we can see, different oxidation states? Would it affect on the reactivity of this polyoxymethylate towards dioxygen? So we studied same reaction in this theoretical study, only with three types of header atoms, with three different header atoms. Theoretical approach used here was the same, absolutely the same as in the previous study.